How many times does this happen to you in Windows? You're opening or saving some file with a program, and it opens to like the My Documents directory or something random, and you gotta either navigate all the way over to the window you were just working on in Explorer, or you gotta go to Explorer and copy the path and then paste it into the dialog window. No more. I created a new tool, mostly for myself, but I figured everyone else could find it really useful too, where it lets you just use a hotkey of your choosing, and it pops up a menu with all the active windows that are open elsewhere with Explorer and lets you click it and it'll automatically move the window to that location. I'll show you a more specific demo in a second, but it's pretty straightforward. I'll put the link in the description. It is open source. I actually used auto hotkey and then I compiled it. So why don't I go to the computer and give you more details about how it works? The premise is very simple, so I'll just show you a little bit more of the extra features for it. All right, so this is the program. It's an EXE, but it's written with auto hotkey, and I'll put a link in the description where you can either get the EXE or the auto hotkey version. If you have that installed, you can do that. Anyway, you run it, and then it'll just show up in the taskbar, and there are some settings that we can look at later, but for now, let me just show you again how it works. So let's say you're in Notepad, and you go to Save As, and it could be any program, and you, again, don't want to necessarily go into the thing and have to find the window and copy it over. In this case, you press the middle mouse button. That's what I have set. And all you do is click on the one that is for the tab that you want to go to, and it'll take you directly to it. But what's the cool thing is not necessarily for these types of windows, because sure, you could just copy and paste the path if you really need to. But what's way more useful, in my opinion, is when you come across older programs like this, for example, where say you go to search for icons here and it brings up this type of dialog to select a file. And this kind, there's no path bar to paste into. It's one of these old selection kinds. So this is really where it shines, I think, where you can, again, press it here and then click the thing and it'll automatically navigate to that folder. And you could do this as many times as you want. Just do that. And here's the really cool thing. It's especially useful, even more so, for these types of folder selectors. You may remember these where you have to like literally navigate and click. You can't even see. It's a mess. And look how small the window is. Again, it works for these, and it actually will navigate the tree behind the scenes. But let's just do that, and boom, it immediately goes directly to the one that I selected. We can do it again. 3D objects, boom, now we're at the 3D objects, and then you can click OK and go directly to it. So this is a major time saver for these types of selector windows as well. And then you'll notice that there is different sections for different windows, and actually, if you happen to use Directory Opus, that's a different file manager that I use, it supports that as well. And you'll notice how it works is it'll be a little indicator for which is the actual active tab in that window. So in this case, the Explorer dialog demo folder is open, and you can see that that is the one with the little indicator next to it, and you can customize that as well. And there's also this clipboard thing down there, and that is because actually if you have a path on the clipboard, it'll detect that and give you the option to paste that as well. Whereas if I just copy like some text there or something, it'll just show disabled, and you can hide that if you want. And real quick, if you're curious how this works, basically it just goes into this box down here, and it turns out that if you put in a path into that box and hit enter, it just goes to it and then also even restores the name that was down there originally. Now, it's a little bit more fancy than simply like moving the mouse down and pasting it in. It actually uses like the Windows API to send a message to tell it to do that. So it's a little bit more reliable than you might think. Now, one quick tip, if you want to use this for elevated windows, so let's say we go and do run as administrator on Notepad. If we run administrator for Notepad and then do save as, you'll notice it doesn't actually work. And that's because the script is not running elevated, but you do not actually have to run it as admin to get that to work, because actually, since this exe is signed and there's a setting that I enabled in the script when I compiled it, if you simply put it into a trusted location, Windows calls it, like program files, and you could just make up a folder. I'll put it in like the TheoJoe folder, paste it in here. So simply from being in there, and I can close this and then rerun it from within program files. And now, If I do it again, it now works. If you're running the auto hotkey version with the AHK extension, there's a different setting. So let's take a look at the settings actually. And this UI access, that's the thing that I was just talking about. You can hover over all these, by the way, to see the tooltips. To get it to work in elevated windows, you just have to check that off. If you're using the auto hotkey version, you don't have to worry about it. If you're using the EXE, you just put it in program files. And again, you do not have to run it as admin for it to work in those elevated windows. So anyway, as for the rest of the settings, you can set whatever button you want here, and it has to be with the auto hotkey syntax. And you can see that if you go here, there's a link and it'll like show you how to name it and stuff. And the tilde here basically is just a thing that makes it so the hotkey that you choose does not like override the normal usage of the hotkey. So I would recommend just having that there. And then say I wanted to change it to like F15. That's actually what I have bound to my macro key on my mouse. And then I hit save. And if you decide to change any of these settings from the default, it'll put your selections in a config file. And by default, it's going to go right next to the script. But if you're in the program files, then it doesn't have access to that. So it'll just put it in app data and it tells you where it put it. Anyway, so it'll just say that the first time you save it. And now that I did F15, I can again do this and you can't see it, but I'm pressing a different key and the middle mouse button no longer works. So it updated that in real time. And there's some more settings here. Like I mentioned with directory Opus, if you happen to use it, you can put that here. Otherwise it won't affect it. It'll just disable that. Here you can change the tab prefix. So this is just the default one. It's just a Unicode character. But if you wanted to maybe make it a caret like that and hit save. And now if I do this, there it now looks like that. So you can put whatever you want really. And that'll be next to the active window for that tab. So for example, the program files TheoJoe is the active one in here. And indeed it is. The non-active prefix, that just makes it so the active ones line up with the non-active ones. Don't worry about that. The debug mode, that just shows like extra tooltips. If you go to use it, you don't want to enable that if you don't need to. It slows things down. And then the always show clipboard menu item, that was this thing that you saw before. So this makes it so, and actually we can use this setting more conveniently here. It just keeps this window open so it doesn't close. So you can see what happens before, where this is showing that the paste from clipboard is disabled. But if you already know that you can use that feature, you can just say uncheck it and it won't show it. And it'll only show the option if you have in the clipboard something that you can actually use. So that's a choice. The UI access, that again is only going to show if you are running the auto hotkey version. And these are self-explanatory. This just makes it so if you're like testing out maybe the tab prefix, you want to make it easier to see as you change it, you can just do that and it'll keep it active. The help settings, I briefly showed this before. It'll show you where the config file is. And then there's the tip basically explaining what I already talked about with putting it in the program files. So yeah, not much more to it. That's pretty much what it does. All right, so let me know what you guys think. It's a pretty straightforward tool this time. I wanted to keep it relatively simple, not to add too much bloat to it. So I'll be using it myself, obviously, and love to see what you guys think. If you want to keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is where I talked about those weird Windows generic keys that you may have seen. Are they illegal to use? Do they even work? I'll put that link right there you can click on. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.